Tom Cruise is like a funny record with a sad twist of reality. When I first got Sonic Collision, a lot of my friends were texting me on the sly and making jokes. It's like, oh, he about to change his number. He about to switch up and go Hollywood on us. And it's sad for a couple of reasons. One, because people actually do that. But on the other end, it's sad because as you begin to grow as an artist and have more demands on your time and on your brand, there's certain things that you used to could do that you can't do anymore. And even people that you're not even really friends with will come out of the woodworks and hit you up on social media and say, hey, remember me from this and that, and people who played you sideways, and people who never listened to your music, and people who had all arrays of relationships with you will come out of the woodworks. And if you don't respond to those situations in the way they think that you should, then they'll just say, oh, well, he's Hollywood. And being a person who's like endured some tough friendships, I really value the people that are close to me. A lot of rappers would get caught up in political games and end up making friends inside the industry with people that never meant them any good. They only meant them harm. And so I'm not one for that. So when you think of Tom Cruise, think of it as my commitment to stay loyal to the people who are close to me and that have been walking with me since day one, even if it looks a little bit flashy. Yeah.